Okay, so we start the class. So, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Because last time I got stuck with my PowerPoint app. So I try another app here to make a presentation. I hope this works smoothly as I want. So today we will talk about a narrative one. So in our module we have a second section or second unit talk about a narrative. But today I will explain about narrative one, and then the next presenters, like the second group will talk about more about the narrative two. So in narrative two, in narrative one we talk about more general things, and in narrative two it goes more deeply. So before we start a narrative, our material. I hope you can finish our assignment, our last assignment about Indonesia should be locked down, but because the coronavirus or not, because this is our fifth meeting, right? Our fifth meeting means we are in the middle of the semester, so I need to collect all of your assignment, all of your all of your assignments. So I have your midterm score that I can input to our university. So I hope I can make it finish until tomorrow. Oh, it should be 5 meetings. Right? Okay, so let me see if this work. So before we start the class, I will, as I said before, this is our midterm, mid meetings in our semester, because the total meetings will be 11 meetings. So the fifth meeting is in the middle of our class. So I will recall one by one section or one by one unit that we have learned before.
Miss, ini bukannya yang presentasi dulu ya, Miss?
The presenter will be next week. Halo, Mbak? Can you hear me?
Next week, Miss?
Yeah.
Oh, saya absen dong.
Next week, yang terakhir itu kan tanggal 22, yang menjelaskan di naratif 2. Isn't it? Right. Saya nggak salah kan? Infoin. Let me see in the group. Benar nggak kalau yang naratif 2 itu besok? Minggu depan?
Yes.
Yes. So, memang judulnya sama karena today we talk about narrative one and next week we'll talk about narrative two. So the second group will present next week. So before we start the class, as I said, we will recall one by one our last four material. The first one is about the descriptive paragraph. I would like to invite who want to give me an explanation about descriptive paragraph. Mbak, siapa tuh? Mbak Eka. Oke, okay, Mbak Eka.
Satu modul bab satu itu semuanya.
Enggak perlu. Anything you know or anything you remember. If you remember all, that's great, but you don't need to explain all. Like some of them.
Tapi boleh di
Kenapa? What kind of text that we can use to what kind of text that descriptive text make? What kind of text?
Sorry,
what kind of text that the descriptive explain? Text jenis apa aja sih yang termasuk dalam descriptive text? Misal kayak apa? Ada contoh nggak? One example about a text about descriptive text.
Bentar ya, Miss. Saya ada catatan saya dulu boleh ya.
Okay, it's okay. Seperti apa sih descriptive text itu? Gitu, kayak gitulah pertanyaannya. Misal, kita lihat teks ini, oh, kita langsung bisa tahu, oh, this is the descriptive text.
Okay. Many example we can find.
Like what? When? Kapan sih kita menggunakan descriptive text? Pertama.
When we want to describe something or place.
Yes, that's the answer that I want. So we use a descriptive text to explain place, to describe someone or something, right?
Something.
Okay, thank you, Mbak. And next, who want to add some more information about descriptive text? I will not mention you. I want to volunteer. Who want to explain more about descriptive text? Because I want to hear from you that it proves that you understand the material. Okay, siapa? Saya. Add more information about descriptive text. Anything you know. I don't need the true answer. Like, I don't need the exactly same with the book. I don't need that.
Oh my God.
I just need your explanation. Batun, you want? It's some more information about descriptive paragraph. Our very first meeting materials. Do you still remember?
Saya lagi ngecek diri ya,
kawan. Apa nih? Volunteer. It will be it. You will get more point for this volunteer. Boleh. Siapa tuh? Mbak Atun?
Mbak Endang.
Oh, Mbak Endang. Okay.
Tadi nanya soal descriptive paragraph ya?
Yes. Anything you know, just say it.
I think descriptive paragraph is just said about something detailed.
Mm-hmm. So the details about everything we describe.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And what else? Do you want to add more?
Just
it. Okay, thank you, Bandang.
Yeah,
the others, I still need one more explanation about descriptive text. You can see about our grammar rules, about post question tag, about passive voice, or anything.
May I introduce?
Okay. Who is that? Mbak Sini. Okay. Please. Time is yours.
Okay. Descriptive paragraph is a way to describe people or maybe the dialogue between some people and some of experiences from anyone in the past.
Okay.
Teach or maybe sharing what there happened in the past to anyone.
Okay. Mbak, aku mau nanya. For example, I give you a descriptive text. What will you imagine? Apa sih yang ada di bayangan Mbak? Misal, about Tasha Kamila. Tasha Kamila is very, very smart girl. She married with one of the famous men, like that. What will you imagine?
Yeah, from describing her, know more about what you're describing.
Oh, yes.
About Tasha Kamila.
Yeah, that's right.
Jadi, so we can learn from the describing text.
Yes, that's
about
right.
About people or maybe person, maybe from the dialogue.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's
or
right.
Or even other people experience. That's where we can learn from them.
Okay. That's excellent. Thank you, Mbak.
You're welcome.
Okay, next. So, about descriptive paragraph, we talk about people's characters and experience, like Mbak Eka said. We talk about the assumption about people, or we can use descriptive paragraph to describing place. The grammar that we use a present and past tense. Of course, we use present tense because we describing someone. It means it's a fact, which is a fact. We use a present tense because it should be on our daily life. And we also use question tag like for example, question tag like, you are a teacher, aren't you? So it's like the question tag used to make it clear, like the question is make it clear like that. And passive voice is the sentence that we use for about, like, for example, the English is taught by me. It's the example of passive voice. It means like in Indonesia, bahasa Inggris itu diajarkan oleh saya. Jadi biasanya kalau passive voice in Indonesia, kalau active voice in Indonesia we say me, and then in passive voice we say di. Jadi kalau active voice itu diawali dengan me, kata kerjanya, sedangkan passive voice diawali dengan kata di. And the next one will be personal letters. Personal letters, who want to explain about personal letters? We still have Miss Darwati, Mbak Darwati, we still have Mbak Fitri, Mbak Hanengsi, Mas Jimmy, Mbak Tia, Mbak Atun. Who want to volunteer to explain about personal letters? You can explain more about the personal letters itself, or you can explain about communal letters or personal notes or the grammar rules that we use in personal letters, everything. I just need your explanation.
Udah mau jawab gak nih?
Udah nih.
Mau jawab lagi lo.
Mungkin butuh dipancing, Mbak.
Mau jawab lagi lo.
Ayo. Who want to answer? Who want to give example about the personal notes? Or apa sih itu personal notes? Apa sih bedanya personal letters dan communal letters? Itu. Siapa nih? Bahar Nengsi? Apa Mas Jimmy? Mas Jimmy biasanya ini. You have something to say, Mas? Apa Mbak Atun? Guys, are you there? I think they are busy. Mbak Atun ada?
Ada.
You want to explain more some thing about personal letters? Just try. Kenapa?
Bukannya Mbak Endang tadi yang mau jawab ya? Siapa sih? Saya.
Mbak Atun.
Oh,
Mbak Tia.
Bilang tuh.
Aku udah bilang.
About personal letters. Oh, saya baru sharing ya. Oh my God. Personal letters. What do you want to explain, Mbak Tia?
Is a letter to friend, to family,
okay.
lovers.
Of course.
The letters is just like a conversation. It contains what you want to say to your friend or your relative or your lovers.
Okay.
And common letters are personal letters. Descriptions of recent events, but they do not contain private or sensitive information.
Uh-huh. Okay, so the difference is personal letter is more personal, more specific, or more sensitive, and communal letters is for
recent events, even like news. Just
yes. And also, we can use communal letters to send to one, two or more people, right?
More people, yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you, Mbatia.
You're welcome, Miss.
So, if gak ada lagi, let me help you to re-explain more. So, exactly what Mbatia said, that personal letters is a letters that we use to communicate with our lovers, our family, our friends, and we use a present tense agreement. Present tense agreement means how you agree the subject and the subject and the verb is the same thing. Like, kalau subjeknya tunggal, the verb it should be matched with the subject. And also the communal letters. Communal letters is like Batia said, that communal letters is the letter that we can use to an event or to give some information to the groups, like one at two or more people. And we use future tense. Future tense is one of tense that di ciri-ciri dari future tense itu dengan menggunakan kata will. So the future tense itself, we have future simple future, we have a future continuous, we have future perfect. Nah, and the coordination dan subordination. Saya salah baca. Jadi communal letters itu berbicara tentang coordination and subordination. Coordination itu sama seperti conjunction atau jembatan dari one sentence to another sentence. And subordination also digunakan seperti coordination. Subordination seperti and, but, for, or, so, dan yet. Sedangkan subordination ada beberapa daftar subordination seperti after, since, because, dan yang lain-lain. And sedangkan personal notes sendiri itu biasanya adalah sepercik surat, seperti itu, sepercik surat that we use to give someone a simple thing or a simple message that you want to tell with that one. For example, like orang yang lagi buru-buru nih, nggak sempat kirim surat apa gimana, nggak sempat bilang sesuatu sama seseorang tersebut. So someone will leave a personal notes to another one, like that. And we focus on adjective and adverb. Adjective sendiri itu adalah kata sifat yang mana menjelaskan kata benda, dan sedangkan adverb itu adalah menjelaskan kata adjective dan verb. Nah, sedangkan di business letters, apa masih ada yang mau menjelaskan tentang business letters? I don't think so. So, if the difference between the personal letters and business letters, personal letters ya sama dengan judulnya, personal, dari someone to someone. Business letters itu digunakan ya yang lebih official atau yang lebih formal things. For example, complaint letters or memos or letters to editor. Complaint letters sendiri yang namanya complaint. Jadi if you get something that you didn't want to, like you are in the restaurant and then you find a food is not really delicious or not really delicious. You find the food is something, for example, di foodnya ternyata ada yang kurang matang atau something like that. You want to complain to the restaurant, you can use complaint letters. Complaint letters, kita fokusnya berbicara tentang past tense, yang dimana hari ini we will talk more about past tense too, dan juga memos. Memos itu adalah sesuatu yang kita gunakan untuk menyampaikan juga sesuatu. Pokoknya dia berbicara tentang letters juga. Sedangkan letters to editors, yaitu apa ya? How if you have an idea, if you have something to tell about people, you can use letters to editor. It means that you give an idea to the magazine or to the newspaper, and then your idea will be coming up to the newspaper or the magazine. Jadi biasanya letters to editor itu ya digunakan buat para penulis yang banyak idenya gitu, terus apa ya, karyanya itu mau ditampilkan di suatu tempat yang bisa digunakan sama orang-orang, yang bisa dibaca sama orang-orang. And we talk about gerund and infinitive in that part. Gerund sendiri adalah kata kerja yang dibendakan, which is like swimming. Swim itu kan kata kerja, kita tambahkan ing itu sudah menjadi kata benda yang di mana dia itu pokoknya kata kerja yang dibendakan, gerund. Dan ada beberapa kata kerja yang must be followed with gerund, ada juga kata kerja yang must be followed with infinitive, dan ada juga kata kerja yang must be followed with to infinitive. And last week the first group talking about basic essay. It will be more complex about if we talk about descriptive text, it's just a simple text, personal letters also, business letters also, and basic essay it will be more complex writing, because you should have more ideas about more information about what do you want to write, like our last assignment. About we talk about Indonesia should be locked down or not, about because the coronavirus, something like that. So in the basic essay we have three parts to developing topics, how you develop your topics. We use parallelism. It's actually is almost same with the agreement. Jadi bagaimana caranya dibuat paralel antara subjek dan kata kerja. Sedangkan in basic essay, in the open composition, it means how you develop an essay. Gimana caranya kita menulis sebuah tulis academic essay yang sudah yang belum ditentukan idenya. Jadi misal pokoknya idenya bebas gitu. Terus kita menulis apa yang kita mau tulis, seperti itu. Sedangkan close composition sendiri itu adalah perintah untuk menulis yang dimana judulnya itu udah ditentukan oleh si tim penilai misal. Pokoknya kayak tugas kita kemarin, it's one of the close composition because I made the title of your essay. Some of your essay I have read about some of your assignment, and that's really great. Like your idea is really amazing about the coronavirus. So sampai sini about our four less material. Do you have explanation? Do you have a question? What explanation? Do you have a question, guys?
No, miss.
Okay. So, our topic today, before we start, of course, I will give you some words to motivate you. I hope these words can motivate you. Go for it, whether it ends good or bad, it is an experience. Jadi, apapun something that you face, and then you get difficult to think, is it good or bad? Just go for it. Kalaupun hasilnya buruk, itu adalah apa? Experience. Kalaupun hasilnya baik, ya alhamdulillah. Gitu. So, narrative essay. Narrative essay is a story which focus on an event or a series of events in the past. Jadi kita harus garis bawahi itu kalau naratif itu talk about the past event. Sesuatu yang sudah terjadi kemarin. Ya, semisal kenangan sama mantan, ya kita bisa tuangkan itu ke dalam narrative essay. Misal yang habis jalan-jalan, misal habis liburan kemana gitu, you can write it on the narrative essay.
Oh, ini narrative paling cocok ini buat narrative essay buat saat
ini. Oh, banyak ini ya, banyak cerita ya,
masuk.
Everybody has a story, right? About your past story. Sometimes we use a narrative essay to write your memorable story. Like one story that you really remember that you cannot forget about it. Sometimes we use it in the narrative essay. So, narrative essay usually gives the events in order to in which they occurred. So, jadi di mana memberikan apa penjelasan itu dengan cara in order, artinya tersusun. Jadi misal di hari pertama saya gini, misal berbicara tentang liburan, terus awalnya saya kesini, terus and then saya ke situ dan sebagainya. Jadi in order in which they occurred. For example, a short story, a vivid tales, or experience. Jadi biasanya juga naratif esai itu ditandai dengan fairy tales. Misal cerita Cinderella, atau cerita Keong Mas, atau Golden Egg, or something like that. So, it talk about past. Jadi, ya, kita nggak boleh baper-baper. Oh. Aduh.
Jadi naratif essay itu maaf.
Iya, iya. It's okay.
Jadi naratif essay itu enggak harus selalu real things gitu ya, misalnya.
Iya, enggak perlu, enggak harus.
Jadi bisa our imagination.
Yes.
Itu udah masa lalu gitu.
Ya. It can be a spoof story, it can be a fairy tale. Pokoknya cerita-cerita legend juga itu termasuk narrative text.
Kalau masa lampau tapi itu cerita horror, itu masuk narrative text nggak?
It could be jika itu adalah experience, Mbak bisa jadi masuk narrative text.
Tapi kalau cuma
angan-angan, apa bayangan? I think so. Yeah, itu bisa di-apply dalam narrative text. So, the important thing to remember when writing narrative essay. Ini misal nih, siapa nih bagusnya? Mas Jimmy. Mas Jimmy lagi nulis a narrative essay. So, Mas Jimmy should think about the first one, list the events. Jadi, list dulu events-events atau kejadian-kejadian apa saja yang terjadi pada saat cerita itu terjadi. Yeah, for example, like I don't want to talk about the horror story. So for example, like the experience go to Candi Borobudur. Jadi go to Yogyakarta. Jadi, for example, the first day went to
Jakarta terus ketemu hantu.
Aduh. No. Jadi, for example, in Yogyakarta, the first day you went to Candi Borobudur, and the second day you went to Malioboro, and the third day you went to Taman Sari, for example, like that. So, you can list the events. Dan the events ini bukan cuman tujuan atau yang, bukan cuman tujuan kayak Candi Borobudur dan lain-lain, but the events here means that what happens there. For example, you took a picture, you talk with foreigners, or you eat, you tried some traditional food, pokoknya event apa sih yang terjadi gitu. So think about your story, narrow the fact, the focus, and make a list of things that happen. Ini yang paling penting, karena kerangka dari menulis itu sebenarnya sama seperti basic essay kemarin. We should have the lynch or a bunch of information that so that we can easy to write down. The second part is put events in order. Ya, seperti seperti ciri-ciri naratif teks itu kalau dia harus in order atau harus bersusun. For example, decide your ideas of the focus of your essay. See the list and cross out irrelevant events. Jadi ini kita mulai narrow atau mulai mempersempit ide-idenya. Jadi misal ada ide yang, oh kayaknya ini nggak penting untuk dicerita. Okay, move, kayak gitu. Put the numbers of the event in order they occur. Ini sama sih yang pertama dan ketiga. And the last one is add details and specific information. Jadi pokoknya biasanya di sebuah teks itu what you can sell on your writing. Apa sih yang kalian bisa jual dalam tulisan kalian? Why people should read that story? Sometimes karena biasa mengandung cerita lucu yang wow, ini sangat menarik gitu. Jadi di naratif teks sendiri juga we have to put something that we can sell to the readers. Jadi for example, include what things look like and what people say. Jadi more details, pokoknya we have to put something that really important to know. Why? Okay, di naratif teks sendiri, yang pertama itu how you write the experience. Writing experience, it means is usually written by the first person. Jadi biasanya kita menulis experience itu biasanya kita menulis untuk experience kita sendiri atau pengalaman kita sendiri. It means I. However, the third person, she or it, can also be used if we talk about someone's experience. Tapi kita juga bisa menceritakan pengalaman orang lain. Misal pengalaman mama atau pengalaman adik yang udah diceritain ke kita, itu kita juga bisa menceritakannya. So, things to remember before writing the experience. The first one is choose one experience you remember best. So, you don't need to write down something that ketika kita menulis sesuatu itu kita stuck karena kita nggak ingat lagi gitu. Jadi pokoknya yang diingat yang bisa ditulis. Terus write general statement, give sufficient details about the people and events, and state a conclusion in the end of the paragraph. Sama seperti basic essay, we have to have a conclusion. A conclusion is very important in the essay. Why? Because some people just read the first paragraph and the last paragraph, as I said before. So that's why put a conclusion is very important to the essay. Dan kadang di naratif teks ini sendiri, conclusionnya itu kadang kita, I feel so happy about my journey. Or for example, I feel so sad because... karena selama perjalanan itu hujan, jadi saya nggak terlalu ini, for example like that. Jadi pokoknya konklusi atau kesimpulan yang terjadi pada saat experience tersebut gitu. Nah, writing experience, kita itu berbicara tentang bagaimana kita melaporkan sesuatu, how we report our experience. So that's why our grammar focus today is reported speech. Reported speech itu kalau dalam bahasa Indonesianya kalimat laporan. Gimana cara kita melaporkan ke suatu kejadian? Nah, it's more complicated actually, but if you get understand exactly the point, you will understand more. Jadi, it's used to repeat the exact word that somebody said. For example, my mom told me you have to work harder at school. Ini directnya atau kalimat secara langsung. Jadi di reported speech itu, we have to know there are two reported speech. Ada satu yang direct atau secara langsung, and one the other one is indirect atau secara tidak langsung. Jadi maksudnya kenapa saya sebut secara langsung? It means like my mom told me. Jadi mama saya itu yang bilang langsung ke aku gitu. You have to work harder at school. Jadi dia menyampaikan secara langsung. That's why in direct sentence sometimes we put tanda titik dua seperti ini di atas. Jadi it means it's a direct dialogue. Nah, sedangkan indirect itu adalah kalimat yang sudah disampaikan seseorang secara langsung dan saya menyampaikan kalimat tersebut ke orang lain. Jadi misal mama saya sudah bilang seperti itu, terus mama saya sudah bilang you have to work harder at school, dan saya cerita sama teman saya gitu, bilang my mom told me that I had to work harder at school. It means it's indirect, tapi kata-katanya tidak diganti gitu. Maksudnya inti dari katanya kalau kita disuruh work harder itu nggak diganti, tapi melalui saya yang bilang itu mama saya gitu. Nah, rules of reported speech, the first one is statement sentence. Jadi ada beberapa jenis sentence yang digunakan di reported speech. Kalau statement sentence itu when reporting a statement generally use that. Jadi kan misal di kalimat direct speech itu, kalimat langsung itu dipisah antara koma, dengan koma dan kalimat yang disampaikan. Sedangkan kalimat indirect itu kalau dia bentuknya statement atau bentuknya sebuah pernyataan seperti ini, you have to work harder at school. Ini adalah sebuah pernyataan. Jadi kita menggunakan kata that untuk menyambungkan kata sebelumnya dan kata setelahnya. Contoh yang lain, the suspect promised us that they would tell the truth. Nah, ini adalah kata yang pertama yang disambung dengan kata that kalau dia adalah sebuah statement. Tapi kalau dia sebuah pertanyaan, itu nggak bisa menggunakan that. We will talk about it. Nah, sedang the next one is question sentence. Question sentence sendiri itu when reporting a question, generally we use if. Jadi bukan that lagi kalau dia sebuah pertanyaan. Jadi kita menggunakan if kalau itu adalah pertanyaan yes atau no. For example, do you want to go party? Ya, itu kan kita butuh jawaban yes atau no. Jadi kalau pertanyaannya bentuknya kita butuh jawaban iya atau tidak, it means we use if. Kita menggunakan kata if. Tapi kalau kita pertanyaan itu berupa 5W plus 1H, 5W plus 1H itu seperti what, when, why, where, dan sebagainya itu, kita menggunakan 5W plus 1H sendiri. Jadi misal, my mom asked me if I go to the party. Dan ingat, kalau di sentence itu biasanya kan kalimat directnya dia ada tanda tanya. Sedangkan kalimat indirectnya itu sudah tidak ada pertanyaan lagi, tanda tanya lagi, jadi langsung diakhiri dengan titik. Kalimat directnya seperti ini. Misal, my mom ask, are you going to party? Jadi pertanyaan kan. Terus kalimat indirectnya, my mom ask me if I was going to party. Seperti itu. Jadi, dia menggunakan kata if yang mengganti that atau yang membatasi antara kalimat pertama dan kalimat kedua. Sedangkan kalau dia 5W plus 1H, kalau di sininya when, kita move when itu ke sini. Jadi dari direct itu menggunakan when will you call me, dan kalimat indirectnya juga tetap menggunakan when. Kalau yang yes no itu kan tidak ada kata if atau kata bantu yang lain, jadi kita menggunakan if. Kalau when, kalau 5W plus 1H, kita akan menggunakan when lagi. Jadi seperti itu. I hope you didn't get confused. Did you follow me?
Yes.
Okay.
Miss, sorry, ini saya ada pertanyaan. Yeah. Ini contoh gampangnya. Contoh gampangnya kalau reporter speech itu directnya umpamanya tuh dramatic told me I have broke up with my boyfriend. Terus indirectnya itu berarti dramatic told me that she was broke up with her boyfriend.
Yeah. Ya, betul.
Jadi yang direct message itu Darwati ngasih tahu saya, directnya itu saya ngasih tahu ke semua orang gitu.
Iya. Membocorkan rahasia.
Sekali. Oke, okay, gitu.
Persis. That's a really a good example. Jadi intinya seperti itu. Kalau dia adalah statement ya. Nah, the next one is ada juga beberapa verb yang menggunakan indirect object. Indirect object itu adalah objek yang sebelum kata sambungnya, seperti sebelum kata that, sebelum kata if. For example, like he told me that he was hungry. Nah, kenapa di sini ada verb using indirect object seperti verb told, informed, dan reminded? Karena itu dia adalah udah peraturannya. Kalau muncul kata told, informed, dan reminded, you have to use indirect object. Kalau di sini kan karena dia kata ask, for example, di sini the suspect promised that, ini nggak ada kata ask-nya juga, nggak ada indirect object. Indirect object ini ask, itu nggak apa-apa. Tapi kalau dia verbnya told, informed, dan reminded, itu harus menggunakan indirect object seperti me, us, dan sebagainya. Pokoknya harus menjelaskan dia bilang ke sama siapa sih, dia tanya sama siapa sih. Jadi harus jelas objek yang dikasih tahu seperti itu. Verb optional using indirect object. Jadi ini sebenarnya dia optional, dia bisa menggunakan indirect object, dia juga tidak bisa tidak menggunakan indirect object. Makanya saya menggunakan kata di sini may. For example, he answered me that he couldn't help. Dia menyimpan di sini kata me, atau kita juga tidak menggunakan kata me di sini. It's okay, why? It's okay, nggak ada rules. Nah, ada juga verb using to before the indirect object. Jadi verb seperti said, explain, exclaim, dan complain. For example, Eka said to her husband that she was hungry. Jadi harus menggunakan kata to. Jadi nggak bisa Eka said her husband that, seperti itu. Kalau karena dia menggunakan said, jadi artinya kayak ada ke siapa gitu kan. Said, explain, exclaim, dan complain. Dan juga reporting comments, orders, request, and suggestion. Jadi reporting perintah, request, ataupun sugesti atau suggestion bisa menggunakan five step. Five step-nya itu he said don't run. Jadi directnya ini for example, he said don't run. Jadi kayak dia langsung bilang jangan lari gitu. Kalau kita merubah ke indirectnya, he order me not to run. Jadi ini bentuk negatifnya. Sedangkan kalau bentuk yang lain seperti she told open the door. Nah, indirectnya itu she told me to open the door. Bedanya di sini kalau apa namanya, kalau dia negatif kita harus menggunakan kata not to. Sedangkan kalau dia positif harus menggunakan to. Jadi kayak udah berapa nih? Tadi ada that, ada if, ada juga double 5W plus 1H, dan juga ada not to dan to. Not to dan to ini digunakan untuk comments, order, dan request and suggestion. Seperti itu. Jadi kalau dia adalah sebuah perintah, jangan menggunakan that. Atau dia sebuah perintah, jangan menggunakan if, kita harus menggunakan to. Kita lihat perintahnya itu dalam bentuk positif apa negatif. Sedang kalau bentuk negatif, it means you have to put not before to. If the comment is positive, you have to put you didn't have to put not. Like that. And the rules of reporting question. Jadi ada rules yang kita gunakan untuk reporting question. For example, the formal form of question is, jadi formal formula yang formal itu kan dalam question adalah question word seperti what, who, where, dan sebagainya. Auxiliary, auxiliary bisa am, is, are, atau bisa kata kerja langsung, verb. Subject, verb, dan complement. For example, where is your father working this day? Atau are they going to the picnic? Seperti itu. Nah, ini dalam bentuk direct atau kalimat secara langsung. Sedangkan kalimat indirect, itu question formnya menggunakan question word seperti why, where, dan sebagainya. Subject, auxiliary, verb, dan complement. Jadi yang berbeda adalah ininya saja, auxiliary dan subjectnya. Jadi dia berubah, jadi bukan question lagi. For example, he asked me where my father was working this day. Jadi langsung menjadi sebuah kalimat. Jadi nggak ada dibalik lagi, nggak ada pertanyaan lagi. Dan juga tanda tanyanya hilang. If they were going to picnic, karena dia pertanyaannya, are they going to picnic? Karena butuh jawaban yes atau no, makanya pakai if. Dan ini karena dia where is your father, menggunakan 5W plus 1H, makanya dia menggunakan 5W plus 1H-nya sendiri. Notes. Notes yang paling penting ini harus dicatat. Yang pertama, indirect speech atau question itu, tensisnya selalu mundur satu kali lebih lampau. Misal direct, kalimat directnya itu menggunakan simple present, so kalimat indirectnya menggunakan kalimat simple past. Jadi kalau dia simple past, berubah menjadi past perfect. Pokoknya dia selalu, tensisnya selalu mundur satu langkah. For example, here, you can see, are they going to the picnic? Are they going to the picnic? Ini adalah kalimat continuous. Present, kalimat present continuous yang dimana terjadi pada saat present, pada saat sekarang. Tapi kalau dia dirubah menjadi indirect question, it means you have to move one step past atau move satu kali lebih lampau ke belakang gitu. Jadi berubah menjadi were, bukan pakai are lagi, jadi pakai were. Jadi dia mundur satu kali lebih langkah menjadi past continuous. Gitu. Dan the other is no commas and question mark in reported questions. Karena kenapa aku bilang gak ada koma lagi dan tidak ada question mark? Karena dia sudah berubah menjadi kalimat seperti biasa. Kenapa tidak ada koma? Karena dia sudah ada memiliki konjungsi atau conjunction atau jembatan yang menjembatani antara kalimat pertama dan kalimat kedua. So we didn't need to put any commas there. Jadi sudah ada where yang mengganti koma. Seperti itu. Ada pertanyaan tentang reported speech? I really like to explain reported speech. It's really really a good material. Ada pertanyaan? I need question. Apa nih?
Saya tanya lagi loh.
Okay. Bertanyalah. Gak apa-apa. I want to explain more.
Coba yang page 9 tadi.
Page 9. Wait. It's okay. This one?
Saya rasa itu yang verb using refer ke indirect object itu contoh kalimatnya kurang itu.
Kenapa?
Eka said to her husband, play that she was happy.
Okay.
So,
oh. I should mention the name. Okay, okay. Ada pertanyaan lagi? Jangan pingsan lah. We will have activity one if you don't have any question. But before that, we will have a break. 5 minutes. Okay. 8:52. Okay, we come back again with me. Baika, I just received your assignment.
Sorry.
Okay, it's okay, it's okay.
Wrong.
Okay, let's start with our activity today. I will call a name. Jadi, yang belum berbicara hari ini. Mbak Darwati, are you with us? Mbak?
Yes.
Okay, could you please? Jadi, pertanyaannya ini change into sentence. Change the sentence into indirect form.
Jangan kalau jawabannya salah nilainya kurang 10 loh dan.
Enggak, Mbak. Nomor 1, Mbak. Di mana?
Michel said that he lives in Paris.
Michel said
that he lives in Paris.
He live-nya tulisannya gimana, Mbak?
Pakai
ed in Paris.
Pakai ed.
Jadi benar sekali karena dia adalah apa nih Mbak? Statement. Dia menyatakan kalau oh saya tinggal di Paris gitu. I live in Paris. So, maybe Michelle friend said, "Oh, Michelle said that he live in Paris." Jadi seperti itu konteksnya. Okay, thank you Mbak Darwati. And next one will be baik Mbak Fitri.
Fitri kan
oh, okay. Mbak Harningsi. Mbak Aningsi, on number 2. Male taught me don't smoke. Apa tuh?
Male
taught me
not
to smoke. Ini jenis apa sih Mbak kalimatnya? Jenis kalimatnya jenis perintah ya.
Perintah.
Iya, benar. Jadi kalau perintah harus menggunakan not to atau pakai to. Dan ya, karena ini bentuknya negatif, jadi kita harus menggunakan not to. Oke, okay, thank you Mbak Ningsi. Next one will be Mas Jimmy. Mas Jimmy. Are you with us? Do you say?
Yes.
Oh, number 3.
dan abstract.
Bisa.
The most
the postman. Kenapa? Bagaimana, Mas?
The postman asked what your address was or your address is.
What? Ini bentuknya present, Mas. Jadi harus berubah. What's your what?
Your address was
what? Your address was. Okay, let's see our question formula. Jadi pertanyaannya itu, a direct question-nya itu, what is your address? Jadi kita bisa bilang the postman ask. Nah, aturannya itu question tag, jadi pakai what. Terus, subject, what your. Terus pakai, apa nih Mas? Auxiliary. Jadi, you were address. Jadi harus harus auxiliary-nya dulu, baru kata kerja, terus komplimennya. Bisa nggak?
Jadi yang benar tadi gimana, Mas?
Jadi yang benar, the postman wanted to know, atau the postman asked, what?
What
you?
Gimana, Miss? The postman asked.
Okay, wait a minute. Kok aku pusing?
Auxiliary-nya
itu bisa pakai do. Kenapa? Iya, kita mau rubah
yang ke... Yang postman-nya bertanya. What is your address kepada yang itunya? Berarti kan nggak bisa pakai address.
Kenapa? Kenapa? Sorry.
Kan indirect. Address berarti indirect, kan? Ini kan dirubah ke indirect, kan? Itu kan direct-nya.
Oh, iya. What's your address? Oh iya ya. Sorry. Sorry, Mas Jimmy. I forget. Iya. Ini adalah indirect question. Makanya saya bingung, kok ini ya? Thank you, Mbak.
Iya. Bahar Nasi.
Makanya kok bisa jadi question ya? Kok bingung. Sorry, Mas. Yes. Ya. Jadi harusnya gimana nih? The postman asked what your address. Ya, jadi jawaban Mas ini. Iya. Benar. Jadi Mas jawaban. Aha. Kenapa? Iya benar, what my address was. Bukan was, Mas, tetap is.
Optional kalau ada my address. Jadi what my address is or what my address was.
Iya, pakai is. Jadi pas apa kata kerjanya itu nggak bisa diganti. Kok aku bingung jadinya? Bentar, bentar.
Enggak, kalau berdasarkan dari
bisa bisa my address bisa.
Enggak bisa mengikuti formula yang di atas, Miss. Soalnya beda.
Jadi jadikan your itu adalah orang. Oh, saya lupa menjelaskan yang ini tadi. Jadi orang yang pertama itu berubah menjadi orang ketiga, orang kedua berubah menjadi orang pertama, dan orang ketiga dan orang ketiga. Nah, sedangkan ini kan orang kedua. Orang kedua itu berubah menjadi orang pertama. Jadi benar kata Mas Jimmy, kita bisa menggunakan I atau me, my, karena dia menggunakan your. What my address? Gak bisa karena dia pakai your.
Yours pakai, kalau pakai I aneh juga.
Iya. Your itu pasangannya sama me, my, sorry, my. Jadi benar, what's my address is?
What's my address, yeah. Is, apa was?
Is.
Is.
Okay.
Saya pakai was, berarti salah. Okay.
Harusnya nggak bisa pakai was karena dia direct. Dan ini semua... I confused when I make this question actually. Okay, next. Number 4. Thank you, Mas. Thank you, guys. And number 4 is Batia udah. Mas Ahmad bisa bicara enggak sih? Mbak Utin. Oh, enggak, Mbak Utin enggak bisa.
Mbak Utin enggak tahu.
Enggak, iya dia enggak ini. Oke okay, deh, Mbak Eka.
Saya
belum menjawab kan, Mbak Eka?
Oh,
okay. Number 4.
Jill said, I will have arrived at home by 10. Jill said, you will arrive at home by 10.
He?
Said that Jill said, you will arrive at home by 10.
Pakai conjunction apa, Mbak? Conjunction. Pakai if, that, atau... Ini bukan pertanyaan, jadi harus pakai
that.
Ya, that atau told. Bisa.
Oh, pakai told. Bisa, saya juga bisa. Cuma conjunction-nya pakai that.
That, iya, betul.
Oh, okay.
Conjunction-nya pakai that. Sorry, Jill said that
he would.
Yes. Will-nya berubah menjadi would. Oh iya, yang confused karena sorry saya tidak menjelaskan ini yang tadi. Jadi orang yang pertama itu adalah I, we dan we. Orang kedua itu you dan orang ketiga he, she, it dan they. And number 5 will be.
Ya. Yeah.
Yeah, would. W O ya harus pakai have.
Harus pakai have tapi tadi saya lagi kan kok
enggak pakai
have sih. Kenapa? Have itu cuma pakai
karena dia ini bentuknya future perfect. Jadi harus pas future perfect. Lebih lampau lagi. Halo? Oh, why? Guys?
Yes. Harus pakai have lagi kan? Tapi tadi saya cari contoh di internet kok nggak pakai have?
Pakai have. Jadi karena kan dia ini posisinya will have arrived itu tenses-nya future perfect. Nah, makanya dia yang berubah ini cuman will berubah menjadi would. Iya. I think so. Okay. And next will be ada lagi ya, Mbak Endang. Mbak Endang? Mbak Endang nggak ada ya. Mbak Darwati.
Bisa coba, Miss.
Oke. Okay. Oke, okay, bisa. Number 5.
My teacher asked was Bobby stupid as he look.
My teacher. Ini dirubah, masnya rubah menjadi aktif. Mas,
ya.
Masnya rubah jadi aktif atau masnya rubah jadi aktif indirect apa direct? Direct ya, indirect ya.
Dengan kalimat direct ya.
Iya, kalimat direct. Jadi rubah ke indirect.
My teacher asks.
Mm-hmm. Konjungsi apa yang dipakai, Mas?
Ask that.
Is that for a question? Kalau question harusnya menggunakan
if.
Yes, if. So, my teacher said
if Bobby
mm-hmm.
stupid as he look.
Yes. Was stupid. Karena isnya kan harus berubah menjadi was.
Jadi my teacher asked if was Bobby stupid as he looked.
Bobby dulu, Mas. Bobby was stupid.
My teacher asked if
mm-hmm.
was stupid as he looked.
Yes.
Jadi looknya plus ini juga.
Ini, iya betul. Berubah dua-duanya berubah. Nah, dia ini yang buat di sini menjadi berbeda karena dia di pertanyaan itu dua kalimat. Ada Bobby stupid and he look. Jadi S-nya ini yang menjadi penengah di antara satu kalimat dan kalimat yang lain. So, both of them should be changed into past tense.
But setelah itu mesti subject baru auxiliary.
Iya, betul. Dia
seperti yang misalnya Bobby asks me where I was sleeping.
Where I
was sleeping.
Mm-hmm.
Berarti direct speechnya where
where is your sleeping? Contoh-contoh. Iya, coba ulang pertanyaan directnya, Mas. Saya mau chat.
Harus subject itu kan formula biasa.
Iya,
where is she? Berarti kalau diterjemahkan ke indirect, jadi where she was.
Yes. Yes, betul. Jadi subjeknya dulu baru auxiliary-nya. Kalau dia indirect. Kalau dia direct, auxiliary-nya dulu baru subjeknya. Contoh lain, misal apa ya pertanyaan? My uncle asked, "Where did you go to school?" Where Did you go to school? Gimana tuh, Mas? Coba.
Where you had gone to school?
Where? You-nya itu berubah menjadi? You. Berubah menjadi I. Kalau your, berubah menjadi me. Kalau you, berubah menjadi I. Karena dia did go, berubah menjadi?
I had.
Yes, that's right. Gone to school. Seperti itu. Did you get it? Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Oh, jawabannya. My teacher said if, kan, karena dia pertanyaan, if Bobby, subjek dulu yang maju, baru is-nya berubah menjadi was stupid as he looknya juga berubah menjadi past. Stupid as he look. Pakai ID.
Looks-nya pas ya, bisa?
Iya, ID. Look.
Iya, iya. If Bobby was stupid as he look. Bobby stupid as he look.
Iya.
Sama. Gimana sih? Nomor 5. Cuma look-nya itu jadi pas. Iya, iya. Maksudnya lengkapnya ini.
Iya. My teacher said if Bobby was stupid as he looked. Udah ya? Mas Jimmy masih ada pertanyaan?
Enggak ada lagi, Miss.
Enggak ada lagi.
Clear.
Bahar Neng sih?
Mas.
Oke. Bahar Neng sih coba nomor 6. Bahar Neng sih. Number 6. Today is my birthday.
Serena said that today is her birthday.
Is berubah menjadi?
Was.
Yes. Was her birthday. Jadi actually kalau kata today itu juga biasanya kita ganti menjadi that day.
Ya.
Itu ada saya kan kirim beberapa contohnya. Jadi kadang now itu berganti menjadi at that time, terus today menjadi that day, tomorrow menjadi the following day dan sebagainya. Good.
Makanya saya tadi will have itu, soalnya saya cari itu, kalau will have itu cuma diganti gitu.
Iya.
Makanya saya confused di situ.
Kalau would terus kata bentuk ketiga, kalau would terus ada dia bentuknya ID, itu biasanya kita gampang would itu tidak bisa apa ya namanya? Models seperti would, can, itu nggak bisa diikuti kata bentuk ketiga langsung, Mbak. We have to put have atau has ataupun ya yeah, have atau has di situ. Yeah. Karena kalau dia bentuknya pas, yang berubah itu modalsnya, will-nya atau can-nya yang berubah dan kata kerjanya itu bentuk pertama. Dan kalau kata bentuk ketiga itu langsung, kalau perfect itu langsung berubah. Kata kerjanya langsung berubah bentuk ketiga, jadi dia tidak akan melalui bentuk kedua kecuali auxiliary. Okay, that's enough for the first unit. We move to the second unit. It's talk about the writing short story. Actually, the second unit and the third unit is very simple one, the simple one. So short story, ya seperti yang kita ketahui, cerita-cerita pendek. is a text that is usually taught verbally. Jadi biasanya kadang ada kompetisi membaca cerita. Biasanya orang yang membaca short story itu menyediakan juga seperti gambar-gambar yang dimana mereka itu langsung menjelaskan ke orang-orang tersebut melalui gambar. Makanya di sini tulisannya taught verbally, karena biasanya short story itu digunakan untuk disampaikan secara langsung atau verbal. For example, a legend story or someone's experience, of course. Jadi saya mengambil di sini contoh the golden egg. Ini the golden egg ini apa namanya? Contoh a short story. Karena kayaknya we don't have we will have.
Itu kayak story-nya terlatih.
Oke, okay, kalau gitu we will invite Mbak Darwati. Mbak Darwati to read the golden egg story.
Saya baca, Miss.
Iya, Mbak Darwati.
Oh, Darwati.
Mbak Darwati, are you with us? Can you read the story, the whole story, Mbak?
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
The golden egg. Once upon a time, a farmer had goose that laid golden egg every day. The egg provided, you know, money for the farmer and his wife for their day-to-day needs. The farmer and his wife were happy for a long time, but one day the farmer got an idea and thought, why should I take just one egg a day? Why cannot I take all of them at once and make a lot of money? The foolish farmer's wife also agreed and decided to cut the goose's stomach for the eggs. As soon as they killed the bird and opened the goose's stomach to find nothing but good and blood, the farmer realizing his foolish mistake, cries over the lost resort. The English idiom, kill not the goose that laid
the golden.
Kill not the goose that laid the golden eggs was also derived from this classic story.
Yeah. Jadi hikmahnya di sini jangan terlalu serakah. Jadi jangan terlalu serakah karena dia udah mendapatkan one egg a day, dia mau more gitu. Ya, tapi namanya manusia ya.
Satu saja cukup.
Ya, satu saja cukup. That's very great. Okay. Karena kita berbicara short story, as we see here, itu semuanya menggunakan simple atau semuanya menggunakan past tense. Kita sudah belajar tentang past tense sebelumnya, jadi seperti laid, had, decided, killed, opened, dan sebagainya. Nah, kita bisa lihat di sini past tense sendiri ini cuman tambahan additional explanation about past tense. Karena menurut aku ya Mbak dan Mas ini udah mahir dengan past tense ini. Nah, past tense ini spesialnya dari present dan future karena dia ada aturan yang dimana memiliki regular dan irregular verb. Atau regular yaitu beraturan, irregular verb artinya tidak beraturan. Nah, kenapa dia dikatakan beraturan? Karena dia take an ed or d ending. Jadi cuma ditambahkan ed atau d di belakang kalimat di belakang kata kerja yang sebenarnya. Sedangkan irregular verbs is change the words internally. For example, watch Korean drama and I ate pizza yesterday. Ini berubah dari kata eat menjadi ate, dan ini dari kata watch nggak ada id-nya terus berubah menjadi id. Nah, kadang orang bertanya gimana cara bisa membedakan antara regular dan irregular verb. Then I until now I found nothing. I found nothing to explain what should we do if we get stuck and we don't know it that it is that regular verb or irregular verb. Jadi ya intinya we have to read more and we have to know more about the regular dan irregular. Gitu, jadi nggak ada cara lain. Ya, we have to know about by reading. Then a troublesome verbs in the past. Jadi seperti yang kayak ini, can, could, will, would, shall, should, may, might, dan must itu adalah modals. Kita sebut dalam bahasa Inggris adalah modals. Modals itu ya seperti ini. Jadi for example, Ben is a good singer because he can sing well. Nah, when Ben was 15, he could sing Mexican song well. Jadi kadang kata can di sini artinya shows the action in the present karena dia menggunakan kata can. Sedangkan could itu shows the action occurred in the past. Jadi ini sama dengan kata yang will sama would tadi di contoh reported speech. Jadi pokoknya kalau dia can itu something happened in the present dan kalau could itu dalam bentuk pastnya. Sama dengan will dan would. For example, Ben said that he will sing in the party tonight. It means points to the future from the present. Dan sedangkan Ben said that he would sing in the party that night, it means that points the future from the present. Ini artinya point the future from the past. Nah, activity ya karena menurut aku simple past itu past tense itu ya we have learned 3 times for this semester, so I will go through it. Nah, mungkin I will move to the third one. If we have more time, we will do this activity. Nah, yang ketiga yaitu writing circular story. Circular story itu it means like the story that begin and end at in the same place. Jadi it a story that begin and end with the same sentence or a description of something happening. Jadi in addition your imagination and creative are really demanded. Artinya kalau kita menulis tentang circular story artinya circle atau kejadian yang dimana dimulai misal ceritanya itu dimulai di rumah dan akhirnya dia kembali ke rumah lagi sampai berakhir di situ seperti itu. Jadi pokoknya circle. Model for circular story yang pertama when of course when choose the time for example. Jadi yang pertama kalian harus tahu itu you can choose the time for example in early in the morning or you can say in the afternoon, in the evening or something like that, pokoknya time. Terus where, choose the place, for example in the country, in the home, in the city, in the school. The next one is you choose the situation. For example, very quiet or very loudly or something situation. And then the last one, decide the person whether gender, name, age, and what she or he is doing. Aku lupa satu di sini. Jadi pokoknya kita membicarakan tentang siapa dia, namanya, umurnya, terus jenis kelaminnya apa dan apa yang dia lakukan dalam circular story itu. Nah, I got the example from the internet. I hope you can see. Yang pertama dia dimulai dari sini. Yang pertama ceritanya take him to the movies and then he wants popcorn. He wants to sit popcorn on the trees. Terus he gets a tree. Terus he sees a snowman. Pokoknya circular story itu artinya kayak if apa ya? Cerita yang dimulai dari satu tempat, take him to the movies, dan akhirnya ending kembali ke movies gitu. Cerita yang dimulai dan diawali dengan cerita
kembali
yang sama.
Ke laptop.
Ya, kembali ke laptop. Exactly. Nah,
kita memulai di situ kita
mengakhiri. Ya. Aduh, kok baper gue. Nah, in the circular story we talk about the capital letters. Nah, di sini ini sebenarnya one of my apa ya? My kelemahan. Karena my weakness. Karena kadang sometimes if we write a story or we write an essay, sometimes we forget about the capital letters, the punctuation that we should use in our essay. Meanwhile, the capital letters is very very important. Karena penilaian capital letters itu juga sangat mengambil tempat dalam sebuah essay. Capital letters dan juga apa namanya tadi? Punctuation. Nah, apa-apa saja sih yang harus dikapitali? Apa saja sih yang harus kita mulai dengan capital letters? Yang pertama, you have to capitalize the first word in every sentence. First word in every sentence. Jadi, setiap kalimat yang baru setelah titik, kayak ini kan, the school, bla 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 bla, gitu. And the second is capitalize the pronoun I. Of course, karena I itu, ya kita harus, kita nggak bisa buat i kecil di sini, harus i besar kayak gini. Nah, enaknya biasanya kalau kita writing an essay in a laptop or in a computer, sometimes the word will recognize the mistake. But if we write an essay by our own hand, sometimes we forget. So that's why we have to focus on this part. The third one is a capitalized proper noun, seperti a particular person, place, or thing. Jadi proper nouns itu artinya kayak nama sekolah, seperti ini, Central High School. I went to Central High School. Jadi saya bersekolah di Central High School. Tapi jika kita berbicara tentang high school, for example, pokoknya tentang high school-nya saja, bukan namanya, tapi kita berbicara tentang high school-nya. We didn't need to put capital letters on the high and school. Jadi kalau high school itu ya tetap huruf kecil. And Monday, also we will meet on Monday. Hari itu harus menggunakan capital letters. Tapi kalau dia bentuknya huruf day, dia bentuknya day saja, We didn't need to put capital letters in D. And the fourth one is a capitalize the name of the person, like the president of Indonesia is Joko Widodo. Nah, huruf J-nya harus besar dan pokoknya setiap kata dari nama orang itu harus besar. Kapital. And the fifth one, capitalize geographic names such as cities, states, countries, mountains, and streets, and etc. Like Indonesia, Europe, Mount Everest, Alps, Taiwan, Highway 14, Borneo. Jadi, nama-nama countries, cities, itu harus juga di capital. Terus, capitalize name of organization, business firms, institution, and government bodies. Like, I like girls' codes. Girls Code ini kan nama organisasi. Nah, makanya kita harus kapital itu. Kalau girl-nya saja ya, we didn't need it. The seven is capitalize special events and calendar items like they come home only on Independence Day. Karena Independence Day itu one of the calendar items. Jadi kita harus kapital. Capitalize the name of nationalities, race, and religious. Mr. Jimmy is Indonesian. Ya, karena kita nationalities, jadi we have to put Indonesian here. Number 9 is capitalize the brand names of business products like Pepsi here, And the karena cola itu kayak jenis minumannya. Bukan, bukan. Ini Pepsi, Pepsi Cola gitu. Cola kayak misal Odol gitu, kayak gitu. Pokoknya dia minumannya gitu. And the last one is capitalized name of ships, planets, monuments, awards, and any other places, things, and events. Like Taylor Swift got his first billboard. Billboard itu adalah awards. Jadi, ya harus ada capital letters. Yes. Any question about capital letters and simple and present tense? No, if no, we can talk about our how to say this one. What is that? Our activity. Yang mana?
Apa di saya doang yang selanjutnya putih kosong? Yang di service itu.
Oh iya tak. I don't know.
Di yang lain gak tahu dah.
Mungkin itu. Ke
kayaknya ini. Ada satu slide. Satu lembar putih kosong deh. Apa punya. Oh enggak mis ternyata.
Gak ada.
Ya sorry. Laptop lain yang.
Oke. Okay. The first, siapa yang mau jawab pertama? Read the sentence carefully. Yeah, typo. Carefully, some of them contain verbs error. Ada yang error, ada yang tidak error, ada yang benar juga kalimatnya. Siapa nih yang mau? Iya, ada yang salah, ada juga yang benar. Cuman 6. Nomor 1 siapa? Bahar Nancy. Oke. Coba Mbak. Yang mana? Oh, activity 2, Mbak. Sorry.
Yang mana sih?
Activity 2. Activity 2 ya. Activity, yes, activity 2. Gak apa-apa ya, Mbak Harning sih jawab nomor 1. Gampang kok. Activity 2 page 14. Yang di layar.
Oh, yang di layar. Kiranya buka berisi. Ayo.
Edgar wrapped the package and sent it to Miss Dorothy by bike.
Nama Yulia ya, Miss?
Kenapa?
Edgar wrapped.
Apanya yang salah di situ, Mbak? Can you find the mistake, the error one?
Biasanya cewek itu nggak pernah salah.
Ya, tapi kadang cewek yang jago mencari kesalahan. Gimana, Mas Timmy?
Iya, iya, iya. Boleh, boleh, boleh.
Gimana, Mbak?
Harus pasti ya.
Apanya yang salah?
Bener kayaknya.
Bener. You can see the verb. Satu verbnya kan wrap, satu verbnya send. Apa itu sama? Paralel enggak? Agree enggak? Agreement. Ingat enggak materi agreement kita? Yang kalau di mana di adap apalagi ada n yang di mana dia Harus sama. Jadi jadi send di sini harus berubah kan? Jadi kata pekerja bentuk kedua. Kita diskusi aja kali ya. Nomor dua. Nomor dua.
Dapat nilai ya orang-orang ini aja lah yang diam-diam nggak usah kasih nilai lah.
Oke, nomor two. Is it correct or there is an error?
There's one. Philadelphia.
Philadelphia?
Itu kan Philadelphia, P-nya tetap lah.
Iya, P-nya udah gede.
Gede dong. Ya, itu emang gede. Itu gede, Kak.
Iya, ini gede. Ini kan yang kecil. Aduh, aduh. Kayaknya butuh aku nih.
Salah, nyolot lagi.
Terus, apa dong yang salah? Apanya, Pak? Apanya, Mas?
By foot.
On foot juga it's okay kok.
On foot it's okay loh, Mas. Cewek itu enggak pernah salah loh, Mas.
Lihat dong. Lihat dong di kalimatnya itu ada 1675. Itu adalah kejadian yang sudah
isinya diganti isinya bukan is kan ya?
Iya, harusnya pakai
Mas.
Iya, karena dia sudah lampau kan. Ada yang penanda ini 1675.
Karena sini cewek itu selalu lebih pintar untuk mencari masalah. Untuk mencari kesalahan tetap kenapa pun kelihatan.
Lihat dong.
Kesalahannya.
Aduh. Ya, kita lihat di sini kan. Ini 1675 udah yang terjadi dulu-dulu. Zaman dulu. Nah, is-nya ini harus diganti menjadi was, dan take-nya juga berubah menjadi took. Yes. Nomor tiga. Spaniards feared him more than any other English sea captains. Iya, ini cuma satu kalimat kan, dan kata kerjanya adalah feared. Number four.
Ini juga kan benar.
Really? Are you sure?
Yes.
The old
people had a clever way to locate him.
The autumn bookkeeper had a clever way of writing. Ya, benar juga. Karena dia cuma satu kalimat dan pakai kata had. Number five. Lily and I have a good day.
Harusnya gantikan
have. Kenapa?
Harusnya gantikan
have. Have-nya mengganti have dan yang mana lagi?
We are.
Ya, pakai were. Ini dua-duanya diganti menjadi pas karena dia berbicara pas tentang waktu dia di elementary school. Sudah di masa lalu kan? Iya, sudah menjadi kenangan. Dan ingat, kemarin waktu aku membaca surat, yang tugas surat itu ada beberapa orang yang menulis I and my friend or I and my family. If you write down you and your someone, you have to put someone first and then you put yourself. Yeah, my family and I, my friends and I, my mom and I. So, jadi nggak bisa I and my
friend.
The last one is 3 days ago, the population of the country increased incredibly. Benar atau salah?
Salah.
Yang salahnya apa?
Increase-nya
itu, increase-nya itu harus lampau karena dia sudah 3 hari yang lalu. Yes. Oh. Ini udah. I try this app so that semoga enggak hack. Gak stuck, ternyata stuck juga. Do you still have the time to finish this?
Saya selalu ada waktu.
Okay, we will finish what we finish what we start, right? Okay, the last one is, I know that Canadians celebrate Thanksgiving, but is there holiday in November? Is there?
C-nya kapital. C-nya
kapital. Ya, C-nya kapital. Terus apanya lagi?
November.
What about Thanksgiving?
Thanksgiving.
Ya, itu perayaan. Tapi nggak harus, ya nggak harus, Thanksgiving itu nggak harus kapital. Number two. Samsung mobile phone change. Ya, karena di awal kalimat dan juga merek.
Merek.
Number three.
Aya.
Aya harus gede. Bagaimana dengan literature?
Literature itu hurufnya kapital semua.
Iya, Indian literature. Sama seperti math, English, itu harus kapital karena dia subjek pelajaran. Number four. When. Dan I.
When I itu harusnya W sama I. Kapital D. English juga kapital.
Ya. Trafalgar. Iya, karena dia nama tempat. Yes. Number 5.
M sama T sebenarnya kapital.
Ya, Mr. Clark. Was sitting in the corner of the restaurant. Apa restorannya harus pakai huruf besar nggak?
Enggak.
Restoran itu biasanya dia huruf besar kalau dia adalah part of the name of the restaurant. Misal kayak ya betul. Kalau namanya misal kayak Nisa Restoran, itu restorannya harus gede kayak gitu. Number 6.
Mary,
ya Mary sama N, terus apa lagi? Yes, number 7.
Marina Bay, M sama B-nya harusnya besar.
Ya, Marina Bay itu tempatnya. And the last one.
Karena nama orang, nama presiden,
B-nya, karena sebutan. Kalau D-nya harus besar nggak? Artikel D.
Nggak usah.
Yes. Wow, that's great. Any comment or suggestion?
Nomor 1.
Kenapa?
Skrivingnya seharusnya capitalized.
Apanya? Nomor berapa?
Yes.
Thanksgiving should be capitalized.
T-nya harus capitalized.
Wait.
Special event.
Oh, karena dia ada di kalender ya.
Soalnya special event.
Karena dia ada di kalender ya. Kalender Thanksgiving. Oh iya. Iya. Oh iya. Okay, we change. Thanksgiving should be capitalized. Thank you, Mas Jimmy.
Thank you, Mas Jimmy. Tungguin Mas Jimmy bisa lihat sekarang.
If you have any comment and suggestion, please don't hesitate to let me know, to tell me. And one more quote. Productivity is never an accident. It's always the result of commitment to excellent intelligent planning and focus info. Ini aku curi dari Paul John Mayer. So, that's all for today. I hope you can get more information. I hope that our study become more enjoyable for the next meeting. And don't forget for the next presenter next week. So be prepared and do your best. Thank you everyone and good evening and good night. Have a good, nice sleep. Have a nice dream. Thank you. See you next week.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.